Hello, I want to talk to you about loading sample packs in SuperDirt. We'll have a special sample pack to use through the course, and so I thought it'd be a good idea to start by showing you how to load that up. First of all, let's have a look at it. So it'll look something like this. It'll be in a folder called Samples Extra. Well, it'd be a zip file that you download, and then you'll extract these files. We'll probably add some more to this. So in each folder there is a bunch of WAV files, and I'll show you how to play them. But the first thing is to copy the location of this samples extra folder. So I'll do that, copy, and then paste it here. And what I want to do is this. So use this tilde or squiggly thing, then dirt. And then you do load sample, no, load sound files. To put parenthesis around that. And an important thing is at the end, you have to put slash and then asterisk, which tells it to load all the subfolders inside samples extra. That's the bit which I always forget, so try and remember to do that. So if I load that, you can see it's loaded 16 sample banks. So these are the default ones that it already loaded, and now it's loaded 16 more. So if I wanted to load some, place some files in the CPU folder, I should be able to do that now by doing la-di-da-la. So this colon 2 means play the third one because it starts counting at zero. So this would be the first one. So that would be this file, and then to play the fourth one, I do three. So I could then sequence this. Or I could just put the sound here and then sequence the sample number within that separately with an N pattern. So let's try that. Oops. Yeah. There's a lot of stuff you can do inside this notation, but we'll cover that in a future video. Okay, so it's a bit annoying though to have to do this every time. So what we're going to do instead is put it in our startup file. So let's have a look at that first. So open startup file. I've already got one. I've just got superdirt.starting, but I'm actually going to delete that. Because we need to do something a bit more complicated with more options than that. So I'll just delete that. So now I've got an empty startup file. So now I'm going to find an example startup file with options, which comes with SuperDirt. So let's have a look. If you go to File, then Open User Support Directory, then have a look in Downloaded Quarks. There's a dirt samples file. That's a default folder of samples. You could look in there if you want, but let's instead look at SuperDirt. So this is the actual source code and everything for SuperDirt. But the only file we're interested in is this one here, superdirt underscore startup. So oops, that didn't work. Let's load that up. I'm just going to copy the contents of it. It says something at the top about loading it in from that location, but it's actually easier just to copy the whole thing because we're going to change it anyway. So let's copy that. I'll delete that. I don't need that there. Right, put that there by mistake. So I'll paste that in now. And then I have this. So this is a more complicated version. So instead of doing superdirt start, it sets all these options, and then it will start SuperDirt here and then load the sound files separately. It starts at this point actually. So this is the line that loads the default samples. I recommend that you keep that there because it's nice to have those default samples there. We'll be using those too. And I could just copy and paste it from here, couldn't I? So if I paste this in here, so it's loading the default files, then it's loading these ones. And now I have to remember to put a semicolon afterwards. You see, each line ends with a semicolon. if that's not there, SuperGlider will get very confused. But then if I save that, now every time I load SuperGlider, it will run this and load the start SuperDirt, loading both the default sample pack and this new one. There you go. I'll do that now. So if I go to language, then recompile class library, that's a quick way of just resetting SuperGlider completely. It's the same as closing SuperGlider down and restarting it, but this is slightly easier, I suppose. So I'll do that. And in this window, you should see, there we go, it's loaded the default ones and the new ones. So that's it. And just to double check it worked. Yeah, great. Okay. So that's what you need to do. I'll put instructions in the forum as well and hope that works. If not, just let us know. All right. Cheers. Bye.